Brilliant to see you both here. Thanks for coming and having a chat with us. Now, Gary, people hopefully have been following your fortunes in the DTM series on ITV4 this year. It was looking like a brilliant season until the very last round, wasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it was a brilliant season. We had a really good year, won a few races, and was leading the championship quite convincingly halfway through the year. But towards the end of the season, we had a couple of races where I had a few incidents, got taken out a couple of times, and Bruno just kept me to the title in the end. But it was a really good year, really enjoyed the season, and I'm really looking forward to getting back into it this year and fighting again for the championship.
Well, and hopefully beating all those BMWs and Audis as well. How do you see things shaping up this year?
Yeah, it was really close. I mean, BMW came in for the first year back last year to join Mercedes and Audi, and they won the championship. They won every championship, so Mercedes were really keen to get back on top and try and make sure they don't do it again. So I think it's going to be really close again. The DTM is always really very close, but I'm hoping that we can build a good car that we can go and win races with, and hopefully again I want to be challenging for the championship again.
We want you to do just that thing. I'll keep our fingers crossed for you.
Indeed we will. Alan, great to see you here again. Alan's been popping in to see us throughout the whole of the weekend. Now listen, let me ask you, of the two Le Mans victories, we talked about which one was your favourite one. What was the most challenging time you had in Le Mans?
You mean generally, from start to finish? I think 2011, when I was going off backwards at about 150 miles an hour, it was a bit challenging, to be honest with you. But, Le Mans is a challenge on its own every single year for so many reasons. One is that you build up, right now, we're already thinking about the race and it's in June. All our testing and preparations are already completely planned and can't really be deviated upon from now. And never mind when you get there and your qualifying session finishes at midnight, so by the time you actually wake up on race morning at 6 o'clock in the morning and the race starts at 3, you're really into that point where it is a real test of your endurance. Then once the race starts, you've got a full racing season of Formula One in a day. And so from that point of view, it is a hard, hard job. Add in 55 cars in the competition that we're facing now, then we've got to be really good to actually achieve it.
And also, looking forward to the World Endurance Championship. But great that you've got a home race coming up pretty soon.
Yeah, the best part for me, being British, is that the first round's at Silverstone, and it's a tourist trophy. Second best part is in April, and it's likely to rain. Third part is we've got Quattro, which is four-wheel drive, so we're hoping that it's going to be very wet night. But it's great to start the championship there, and the World Endurance Championship really built on the base of the first year in 2012. And I have to say that we're looking forward to that competition that we're going to have with Toyota.
It'd be great for all those second places to win this year. That'd be awesome. I'll wind up there, otherwise I'll give you a right reply. But ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for Alan Manish and Gary Paffin. Awesome, guys. Thanks for coming to see us.